Hey guys, what's up? My name is Speedbreaker and welcome to another streaming tutorial. Now in today's video I'd like to explain to you how you can stream on a second PC without the need of a capture card. So a two PC stream setup can be very beneficial if you want to have the least amount of lag on your gaming PC. So in my example, whenever I play CSGO, I'm really bothered by the amount of input lag and just overall game lag that is being introduced on the gaming machine because I'm streaming at the same time as I'm playing. So this setup really alleviates all of the lag, while at the same time having absolutely fantastic stream quality. I can stream at 60 FPS, 720p, while having absolutely no lag on my gaming PC. Now let's begin with the technical requirements for a two PC streaming setup. Obviously you want to have two computers. You want to have your gaming PC and you want to have a dedicated streaming PC. Now you need to connect those two computers somehow in order to have the video game footage from the first PC being sent over to the second PC, and in most cases this is done via a capture card, but I'm gonna tell you how it's done over LAN. So the idea behind this setup is that you have your first PC where you stream your footage to the second PC at a very high bitrate, where you re-encode the footage and then send it up to Twitch. In that way, you're not gonna use too much of your CPU on your gaming PC because you're not encoding too much. Sending it over to the second PC where you do all of the heavy encoding, the heavy number crunching, and then send it up to the internet. So basically what you want to have on the first PC is you want to run a session of OBS. You send it over to the second PC. Then somehow you need to kind of receive the stream from the first PC. And in this case, we are doing this with NGINX. So this is a media server where you can do lots of cool things actually. But in this case, we're just gonna listen for the stream. We're gonna receive the stream on the second PC. We open up a session of VLC player, run the stream, have another session of OBS on the second dedicated streaming PC running, where we actually re-encode the stream from the first PC at a lower bitrate, obviously, something that can actually be streamed, send it up to Twitch, voila. Now, the really cool thing about this setup is that my gaming PC is actually connected to the internet via LAN as well. So I have two internet ports on my gaming PC. One is connected to the internet, the other is connected to the second PC. The second PC will actually use the internet connection of the first PC, which is shared, in order to send the video game footage up to Twitch. Now, the only drawback of this approach really is that you're gonna need a special Ethernet cable to connect two computers to each other. Usually Ethernet cables are for connections between routers and computers and not for connections between two computers. For this to work, you're gonna need a crossover Ethernet cable. Now this is just your regular Ethernet cable, but some of the cables are internally crossed over such that the ports are correct. Some motherboards actually do this crossover automatically, and there is actually also adapters out there that you can buy that do this crossover. Or if you feel fancy, you can solder your own Ethernet cable and kind of do the crossover manually. But really, this is just a very small drawback for this approach. It's kind of the only thing that you need if you have a second PC, is all you need really a crossover Ethernet cable, and you're ready to stream on the second PC. Alright, so your first step is going to be connecting your gaming PC to the internet over LAN and then connecting your dedicated streaming PC to the gaming PC over the crossover Ethernet cable. I've already done that, so let's have a look at step number two. So on your gaming PC, you want to set up your Ethernet adapters properly in order to connect to the streaming PC. So right-click on your internet connections, click on Open Network and Sharing Center, click on Change Adapter Settings, and now you should see your internet adapters. So in my case, Ethernet 3 is connected to the internet and Ethernet 2 is connected over the crossover cable to the dedicated streaming PC. Now, first of all, you want to right click on your internet connection, click on status, click on details, and you want to write down some numbers. So you want to write down your IPv4 address, as well as your IPv4 DNS server, as well as your IPv4 subnask mask. Then right click on the internet again, click on properties, click on sharing, and click on allow other network users to connect through this computer's internet connection, and select the network where you have your second PC connected to. So in my case, this is Ethernet 2, so the internet adapter Ethernet 2. Click on OK. It'll take a few seconds. And now you can see that your internet connection is shared over LAN to your second PC. Now, as you can see here, we could actually not connect to the second PC yet. And this is because we need to make some settings in the internet adapter settings here. So right click on the Ethernet adapter that is connected to your streaming PC, click on Properties, click on Internet Protocol version 4, Properties once again, and now you need to enter some numbers. First of all, you want to use a different IP address than you are using in your primary internet network adapter. So in my case, we're going to use 192.168 and 103 instead of the 0.1. The subnet masks should actually appear automatically. And the preferred DNS server, this is important, this should be the same as your primary internet connection. So in my case, 192.168.0.1. Click on OK, close. And if we're lucky, we should actually see that, as you can see right here, it says connectivity internet access, and it says that we're actually connected to the secondary PC. So we are now on the desktop of the dedicated streaming PC. Now let's have a look at the internet adapters on this PC. Right click on your internet connections, click on Open Network and Sharing Center, click on Change Adapter Settings, right click on the connection that you have made to your gaming PC, click on Properties, click on Internet Protocol version 4, Properties once again, and make sure that you obtain your IP address automatically, as well as your DNS server. Now let's have a look at the status. So right click on your connection once again, click on status, click on details. So this PC has the ID 147 in the IP subnet 137. Let's write this down and close this dialog. Now finally, let's test if we actually have internet on your streaming PC. Seems to work like a charm. So now that we have successfully connected the two computers to each other and are using the shared connection from the first PC as internet connection on the second PC, let's have a look at step number 4. Now step number 4 consists of actually setting up your NGINX server on your streaming PC, which is responsible for receiving the stream from the first PC. So you can think of this as a Twitch server, as a kind of a local Twitch server that receives the video game footage from your first PC. So for that, you want to download the NGINX installation that I have put in the description below this video, unpack it to your local C drive, unpack it under NGINX preferably, and then just run the NGINX exe. If we open up the task manager, we can now see NGINX is successfully running. Now I have already changed all of the necessary settings in this NGINX installation such that it will work as a two PC stream setup. But if you want to, and if you know NGINX, you can obviously change some of these settings here. I just use this application live, to which I am actually streaming from my gaming PC. So now that we have our NGINX session up and running, we need to go over to step number 5, which is setting up OBS on your gaming PC. Now open up OBS, preferably the 64-bit version on your gaming PC. 64-bit version, by the way, can be found on your computer, C drive, program files, not program files, x86, program files, OBS, OBS exe. In OBS, click on settings, encoding. Now you want to use a ridiculous high bitrate. Obviously you want to stream your gameplay from your gaming PC to your stream PC at a very high bitrate because you don't want to encode it too much. So you don't want to have too much PC power taken away from your gaming PC. So we stream at 50,000 kilobits per second. Also, I'm using the NVIDIA NVNC codec, and that just basically means that the gameplay footage is encoded on the GPU rather than on the CPU. So that just means that more CPU power is being available for the game. Obviously, if you do not have an NVIDIA GPU, you can also use the X264 encoding or QuickSync if you have that. But then this will introduce some amount of lag on your gaming PC. And as I want to have absolutely no lag on my gaming PC, I'm using the NVAC codec. What kind of audio you use is pretty much up to you. I'm using the highest quality and click apply. Now let's go over to broadcast settings, use the streaming service custom, enter the FMS URL RTMP as we want to stream to the NGINX session, :// the IP address of your dedicated streaming PC. So in my case, this is 192.168.137.147. /, the application of the NGINX session you want to stream to. So in my case, this is live. And as stream key, we're gonna use 1080. So actually you can use whatever stream key you really want to, but once again, write it down. So in my case, I just literally use 1080. Hit apply, hit OK, and this is it. Those are all the settings you need to do on your gaming PC in OBS in order to stream your gameplay from your gaming PC to the dedicated streaming PC. Let's hit start streaming. And as you can see right down here, we have this green sign, which means that this connection to the NGINX session has successfully been made. Great, so in step number 6, we're going to display the stream from the gaming PC on our dedicated streaming PC in the VLC media player. So open up VLC on your dedicated streaming PC, click on Media, open Network Stream, and enter RTMP :// the IP address of your dedicated streaming PC, so this is the PC we're on right now, / the application life, /1080, so this is the stream key you have entered in the first OBS session on your gaming PC. Hit play, and in a couple of seconds you should actually see the stream that is being streamed from your gaming PC to the NGINX server on our dedicated streaming PC, and now we're displaying it in the VLC media player. So the final and seventh step consists of setting up OBS on your dedicated streaming PC and basically importing the footage from VLC. So let's remove this for the sake of the tutorial. Let's add a new game capture source. Select application VLC. Don't capture the mouse cursor. Click on OK and let's preview the screen for a second. And as you can see, we have the stream for our first PC in the OBS session on our second PC. However, you still got these borders here. So go to VLC once again, put it into full window, not windowed, like full screen mode, and go back to OBS by pressing Alt Tab. Let's stop the preview for a second and let's set up our OBS settings on the dedicated streaming PC. So in my case, I am using the NVIDIA NVNC codec once again on the dedicated streaming PC. You usually want to use x264 if you have a very good CPU on your streaming PC. However, my CPU is not so good, so it can actually not stream at 720p 60fps on the CPU, but I have to use the GPU for encoding. Once again, I use 3500 kilobit as bitrate. I use the 128 as audio bitrate. If you go to broadcast settings, you just use your standard Twitch, the closest server, the stream key that's been provided by Twitch. You can use whatever you want here. In the video tab, I use 1920 by 1080 as the native resolution of my monitor on the dedicated streaming PC. Use downscale 1.5, so 720p you want to stream at. The best filter, 60fps obviously. And finally, in advanced, I use the NVNC preset NV default, which gives me the nicest looking quality on Twitch when I use the NVNC codec. If you have a very good CPU, you can use the x264 codec here and then go to something like faster or even very fast. But in my case, this is absolutely not possible. So we're going to go back to the NVNC codec here, use the NV default, and now we're actually able to start streaming. So that's it. That's all you need to know on how to stream using two PCs or a crossover Ethernet connection. If you still have any questions, don't hesitate to leave them in the comment section below, and I will try to answer all of your questions. Whilst you're at it, leave me a like if you liked this video, a dislike if you didn't. Thank you very much for watching. My name is Beatbreaker, and I will see you guys in the next one. Cheers!